storage costs on Ethereum. Once upon a time, things were simpler. If you wanted to occupy a free storage slot in a smart contract, you would pay 20,000 gas units. If you wanted to change the value in an occupied storage slot, you would pay 5,000 gas units. If you wanted to free a storage slot, you would get a refund of 15,000 gas units. If you wanted to read a storage slot, you would pay 200 gas units. Now, calculating storage costs in Ethereum is significantly more complicated. We have several EIPs that have changed and will change the way S-Store and S-Load are priced, like 2200, 2929, 2930, 3529. The gas cost of a transaction must be a marker for the memory and computational resources needed to execute that transaction. These can change with time, especially when there is a growing user base and much more state to read and write, and states are stored in slots. In this video, we will go in detail into the storage cost rules brought by EIP-2200. We will be using the terms original value, current value, and new value, and the definition of these terms can be found in EIP-1283. But we will see them in practice. Here is a first example. We are using EVM assembly code. The first part here is the contract constructor code, and the second part here is the runtime code of the smart contract. This is the part that will be executed when a transaction happens. I'm deploying this short contract on my local testnet. And then I will debug the transaction that executes this runtime code here. So now we have all the execution steps. And we also have the transaction logged here, so we can replay it at any time by clicking on this Ethereum icon. Let's go to the first SS store. So we are starting with a value of 0 at storage slot 0x20, which means the storage slot is empty, it's free. So our original value, the value of the slot at the beginning of the transaction, it is 0. The current value is also 0 because we haven't made any changes. And the new value is 0x3333. So let's see what happens when we do an S store. And what happens is we pay the full storage costs for one slot, 20,000. So we are in this case where the original value is 0 and we have set a value that is different than 0. Next, we have another S store. So at this point, the original value is 0, our current value and our new value are the same. So what happens if, in the same transaction, you change the storage slot twice with the same value? And the second time, you only pay 800 gas units. This is the price for the S-load opcode. So we are in this case, where the current value equals the new value, and just the S-load gas is deducted. Another example. Okay, in this example, we start with a 5 as value for the storage slot at 0x20. So this value has been set inside the constructor at deployment time. So now we are here. Original value 5, current value 5, and a new value which is different. 3333. So what happens at this S store? We pay the S store reset gas, which means the gas cost for changing a storage slot that was already occupied. So we are in this case. And you only pay 5,000 gas cost. And now another example. We again start with an original value of 5 that we can see here. So we have original value 5, current value 5, and we set the new value 0. So what we are doing is freeing the storage slot. So we expect a refund. Let's see. When we do the S store, we have a refund of 15,000 gas cost, but we also pay 5,000 gas cost. We are in this case. The new value is 0, and we have a refund of 15,000, but the S store reset gas is still deducted. So next, our new value is 4. So our original value was 5, our current value is 0, and we again set a new value which is 4. So 15,000 is subtracted from our refund counter, and we need to pay an additional 800. This is for the S-load gas cost, and this effectively means that the refund gas that was awarded when we set our storage slot to 0 now was retracted. So we are in this case. The current value is 0. Our new value is 4. Yeah. So we remove 15,000 gas units from the refund counter, but still we deduct the S-load gas. Now what happens if we want to again free the storage slot and store a 0? So we are in the case where the original value is 5, the current value is 4, and we want to store a 0. Let's see what happens. So our refund counter increases with 15,000 and we pay the S-load gas cost. And we are in this case. The new value is 0, current value is not 0, and we are refunded, but also we pay the S-load gas cost. And we have more S-stores. So now, we are with a current value of 0. The original value was 5. And we want to reset the value to the original value. So we want to store 5. So let's see what happens when we want to S-store. This is a little bit more complicated. So we pay the S-load gas cost, and we want to see what happened here. So original value 5, current value 0, new value 5, the same as the original one. So we are in this case where the original value equals the new value, but the original value is not 0. It was 5. So we add to the refund counter the reset gas cost minus the S-load gas. So this means 5,000 minus 800, it's 4,200. But we have a minus 10,800 here. So what's happening? What's happening is that we have multiple clauses that we can apply to the same situation. And specifically this one. So our current value is 0. Our new value is not 0, it is 5. So we need to remove 15,000 gas units from the refund counter. So that's what's happening here. We remove 15,000, but we add 4,200. And the S-load gas cost that is deducted. And for a last example, we start with an original value of 0. Our current value is 0. We store a 6, but the store that we want to see is the second one. So the second one, we started with the original value 0, our current value is 6, and the new value is 0. So we are again resetting the storage slot, we are freeing it, and we expect some refunds. So we pay the 800 S-load gas cost, and then we have a 19,200 gas cost refunded. So we are in this case where the original and the new value are the same and both are 0. So we are refunded 20,000 minus 800 for the S load. So that's the 19,200 gas cost that we saw earlier. And the S load gas cost is deducted. And these are all the cases. So we had 4 smart contracts for testing, and we have seen what happens when you do a simple S store. Let's replay the first transaction. A simple S store with 20,000 gas cost. We've seen what happens when you change an existing storage slot and you pay 5,000 gas cost. Or what happens when you free a storage slot and you get refunds. And then all the cases where you can have multiple S-store operations in the same transaction and see how the gas costs change. So this was EIP-2200. If you want more videos explaining the rest of the EIPs and how they influence storage costs, leave a comment below.